Hi everyone. On my tax revision sheet, there's a thing called a VAT legislation sheet. And what you can do is if you open it up, it tells you what you should do with each of the tags that you should put in your book. So what's on here? There's a tag, section number, what you should put on the tag, and what you should highlight inside your book itself. Now, what I just would like to actually just tell you is that if you look at my videos and my notes, these tags are in the order of my notes. So if you have a look here, I've got a VAT summary on sundry sections. And as you go through each of the sections in order, what you'll find happening is that I basically try to tell you what you should highlight. Now, what I believe should happen is that everything that's in between two blue lines should be tagged together. So, if I wanted to do importation of goods in the Republic, section 7.1b, it's for input goods, import goods, output charge. So, this says why there's output charge. Section 1 of the definition of input VAT tells you which section you can claim for importation of goods. Section 13.2a and b, how you value goods for import purposes. And section 13.1a tells you the time of supply for invoices. So if you can put these four tags doing the same color, highlighting in the book in the same color, and highlighting on the tag in the same color, and you put these as a bundle together around your book, all next to one another. If you get a question on importation of goods and you need to actually discuss something, you can combine all of these together to answer a question. Here's import of services, commercial accommodation, fixed property, insurance payments, installment credit agreements, rental agreements, repossession of goods, all sorts of stuff in here. So if you want to do that, I think it's a very, very good idea for you to go and tag your books and make sure that you've got all your books properly tagged so that you can answer questions properly.